back, everybody. Welcome back to the Apocalypse Stomach Flu Extravaganza, the night of a thousand things. My next guest is a very beautiful actress. She's on the NCIS show, which airs Tuesdays at 8 o'clock on CBS. Take a look at this.
What do you got, Abby?
Okay, I might have overstepped my bounds here a little bit. I know I'm not a field agent.
Abby.
I called the prison, and I got Lambro's work schedule.
Okay, because?
Because I wanted to compare Lambro's schedule to when the antifreeze showed up in Trimble's system. I also got the urine from Trimble's last drug test. He was clean for illegal drugs, but I was able to figure out when he ingested the antifreeze. 24 hours before the test, Lambro was at a conference in Pennsylvania for a whole week, so it couldn't have been him. Oh, by the way, if they ask you at the prison, I'm your boss.
Please welcome very lovely Pauley Perrette, everybody.
You know how much I love you, and
I love you too.
Loved you for years, but flu. Please come sit really close to me.
No, it's just a joke. I don't really have stomach flu.
But you know what the thing, as far as like what you were saying about not, now that you're married, like not flirting with girls and stuff like this.
Yeah.
This is a great idea, because if you just keep on talking about like diarrhea and flu and stuff like that, you're not gonna have to worry about it.
Yeah, I know.
So you're like miles away. They're just gonna flee.
Well, they were fleeing pretty good anyway, to be honest. I didn't have to bring up any of that. How are you doing? You look well. Are you enjoying the NCIS? Is Mark Harmon treating you right? Because he can be a bastard, you know.
I love him.
He's like the nicest guy in the world, isn't he, Mark?
He's your friend.
I know, that's what I'm saying. But, you know, sometimes he's a bastard, let's be honest.
I love my job.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Still, 6 years
because
later,
you did, well, 6 years now, I met you on the Drew Carey show.
We were on the Drew Carey show together.
You played Drew's girlfriend.
I did.
Believed that.
Yes, they did. I played Drew's girlfriend for a while there. I played his when he wanted to be in a band, and my character dyed his hair blonde and stuff. I think you were on cocaine. No, not you.
Yeah, that's right. No, it was wheatgrass. What are you talking about? No, oh, my character was on cocaine. Yes, I forgot I did that. Yeah.
No, you didn't. You didn't do it.
Oh, I did, but it was before the Drew Carey show. Yeah.
Sometimes they have to write it in, right? If you break your leg or if you have, you know, say, so they just made you a fake
cocaine addict. Yeah.
Got it.
Yeah.
I understand.
Now, I remember those episodes because Drew had his hair dyed blonde, the ratings plummeted, everything went terribly wrong.
And... thanks.
No, I'm kidding. It was good, but what was it? You were in a band, was that right? You were in a band and
I've
he was in a band?
I've been in and out of bands, yeah.
Like, are you in a real band?
Yeah, my new band is Stop Making Friends, but I've been in and out of bands for a lot of time.
What do you play in the band?
Mouth.
I don't know if that technically makes you in the band.
Yeah. It's a joke. You know that's a joke.
You sing?
What did you do in your band?
Pretty much the same.
Exactly.
No, I was the drummer, so I wasn't really involved.
Oh, God.
No, any band I was in...
Wait, do drummers hear all the drummer jokes, or do the rest of us just tell them?
Yeah, no, drummers hear them all, but they're too stupid to understand them.
Yeah. Oh, that's awesome.
They're like, oh, ding, ding, ding.
Yeah. So you just laugh along.
Yeah, oh, everybody's laughing. We must be happy.
Yeah, because they're funny drummer jokes.
They are. Do you know any drummer jokes?
Mm-hmm, yeah, but I can't tell them on TV.
Well, this is really TV as such. This is just,
it's not?
Not really. It's,
am I hallucinating?
No,
it's CBS in the middle of the night. Dream.
Do you take a lot of hallucinogenic drugs? Do you go down to Mexico and get the peyote and go to the desert for a few days, that kind of thing?
No, I'm actually like this all by myself.
Really?
Yeah.
That's nice. It's good. It's convenient.
Yes, it is. So when you, he used to be in a band too.
Past
lives. And then one time we were joking backstage, and this is years ago, and I said, we should do a song together, and which of course is a lie because I would never do it because I would be terrified because I have stage fright.
Right.
But I said, what's your favorite song? And you said, Stairway to Heaven. I was like, dude, you don't actually say Stairway to Heaven because that's like everybody's favorite song. You're supposed to pick something a little more obscure. And you said, okay, Freebird.
I did not say that. Freebird's a great song. I love Freebird. It's got slow, it's got fast, it goes on for a long time.
But you never
it's
said
awesome.
That. Of course you never said that.
No, I never said, I say that? I was lying. It was just a joke. My favorite song is...
If it was a lie or a joke, then you still said it.
Yeah, I guess. I feel bad now. Do you want to go out on the road and do Stairway to Heaven and another Zeppelin cover?
No.
So it'd be fun.
But you should, and I'll clap.
No. Do you tour with your band?
I don't want to tour anymore. Like, I like making music, writing it, I like doing everything else, but like, I don't like getting up there and doing that. So I just make records now. And then now, this crazy thing with NCIS is that there's the NCIS soundtrack coming out on February 10th.
Do you have a song on it?
Well, I do, which is interesting.
Congratulations, fantastic.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
Because... we started talking about it a long time ago just because my character is very music-oriented. So we talked about it a few years ago, and me and one of my producers like, dude, we should make a soundtrack. And it's just been like something we were talking about. And then CBS Records was like, that's a great
CBS
idea.
CBS have records?
CBS, yeah. Like,
I didn't know about this. Why do they get records?
They spin around, and you put a needle on them.
The gramophone.
Play music.
Yes.
But yeah, so we got to talking about that, and then there were... talking to me about doing a song, my Stop Making Friends songs. I was like, dude, my character's not going to be like singing
on
the show.
Who do you call dude, the producer?
You, I think it is.
No, but do you say dude to the producer? You say dude, I can't do that. Do you say that?
Yeah, I think it was him and
he's okay with that.
A bunch of people. Yeah, I don't know if they really listen to anything I say.
Okay. I know.
But it ended up being, I had a song that was, I had another song that was kind of an anti-war song, and that kind of got nixed. But I had another song that they really dug, and now it's a part of the show, and it's going to be on the show, and it's on the soundtrack. But the soundtrack's awesome.
You get some money for that. You get some money for that. Absolutely.
No, they told me that that's all free.
Get a new agent. I'm telling you. No, you get some money for that. I sang the theme song for this show, $20 a week.
Really? That's so weird, because they told me every time somebody listens to a song, I have to pay them $10.
That is CBS right now when you mention it. I was thinking of someone else. Hey, are you going out doing the road trips? Are you still doing that?
Yeah, we just got back. We've been gone for 12 days. We drove across our country.
We would be who?
Me and my beloved Michael. And our dogs in the station wagon. Used to be an old van. The van, first time that broke, that's gone. Well, not gone. It just doesn't move.
Right.
But now it's...
That's definitely a drawback with a motor vehicle. If it doesn't move, it's pretty much done.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, this one moved just fine because it's a Volvo station wagon. And so it's me and Michael and the dogs, and we drove right when we got off work for Christmas holiday. We started driving, and we drove for 11 days straight, and we just got back in time to go to church on Sunday. So we've been driving forever.
You go to church? I didn't know.
All the time.
Really?
Yeah.
No.
How you feeling?
I'm okay. I've got a bit of stomach flu. Did I mention that?
Okay. Well, you know, I was gonna bring you. I had an old dead flower in my car from church on Sunday, and I was gonna give that to you. Congratulations.
Did you steal it from a grave or something?
No, it was just in the thing the thing at the front of the church. But then I forgot that. So
they're not for taking. You know, that's not a party favor.
Oh.
You don't get to walk out of the church. Oh, help yourself with some flowers, everybody. Have a nice day. That's not what they're for.
Really?
They're for decorating the church with a baby Jesus. They're not for you to take out.
Can't get it right. But then I didn't have any. I was empty-handed, and you know, I'm a good Southern girl, so you never go empty-handed. And I was bringing you some asparagus from your green room, but I forgot that too.
I'm going to get it now then, shall I?
It's over there.
All right, the lovely Pauley Perrette, everybody.